In the last video, we talked about what continuous random variables are and how they're described by probability density functions. In this video, we're going to talk about what you can do with those probability density functions and how you can use them to figure out average values and the widths of distributions. Okay, so we're saying that x is a continuous random variable with a probability density function f of x, and you take a measurement of x, and then you set up your equipment again, and you take another measurement of x, and you run the experiment 1,000 times, and you take 1,000 independent measurements of x. In the long run, what's the average value that you're going to get? Now, there's a lot of different notations for this. It's called the mean value or the expectation, and one notation is e of x, means the expectation of x. X bar is another notation. Putting a bar over a random variable usually means it's average. And the Greek letter mu is often used to denote these averages. And if you're asking, the average of which variables, sometimes you put a subscript x to indicate that this is the average value of x. And then if you have another variable y, its average would be mu sub y. Okay, so I claim that this is the right formula for the average. And the question is, why? Well, here we've got our probability distribution, and we want to figure out how many times, if you run the experiment a billion times, how many times do you land in this range? And really, I should cut it finer. So let's say, how many times do you land in this range, where this distance is with delta x? Because what we're going to do is we're going to chop things into boxes, count how many times you land in each one, and then we're going to take the average. Now, the probability of landing in that box is roughly the density times the width of the box. And so if you do things n times, you figure that you're going to land in that box n times f of x delta x times. So when you do your average, your average is going to be the sum of, each value of x times the number of times you get that value of x divided by capital N. And for each interval, we're going to round things off. And for each interval, you're going to get f of x times delta x. And of course, you get more and more accuracy as you chop things finer and finer and finer and finer. And that sum becomes an integral in the long run. So let's see how that works for the distributions we've been talking about. For the standard uniform distribution, I claimed that the average was a half, but here's the calculation. You integrate x times f of x, but f of x is just 1 between 0 and 1. So you integrate from 0 to 1 of x dx, and you get a half. Now, strictly speaking, you should be integrating from minus infinity to infinity. But from minus infinity to 0, f is 0, so you don't get anything. From 1 to infinity, f is 0, so you don't get anything. You really only have to integrate over the range of possible values of x. Now for our exponential random variable, remember the function was e to the minus x. So we integrate x times e to the minus x dx from the smallest possible value, which is 0, to the biggest possible value, which is, you go all the way to infinity. And to do this, you have to integrate by parts. You often have to integrate by parts when you do probability. And then, plug in at infinity really means take a limit as you approach infinity. You need L'Hôpital's rule for that. At the end of the day, you just get the number 1. For the normal distribution, you have to take x times this ugly expression. But you notice that's actually not so bad because you do u substitution, u equals x squared over 2, and you get that this is just minus e to the minus x squared over 2 over root 2 pi, value at infinity and minus infinity, and that's 0. And of course it's 0. Just the whole distribution is symmetric about the origin. On the average, you wind up to the right as often as you wind up to the left. The average is 0. Okay. Now the next thing we want to look at is called the variance. It measures how wide the distribution is. To do that, we say we consider how far off from the average you tend to be. know, if you're 100 plus or minus 1, well, this measures the plus or minus 1. You subtract off the 100 and you see how far off from the average you are. And the average value of x minus mu squared is given by the integral of x minus mu squared times f. And if you expand that out, x minus mu squared is x squared minus 2 mu x plus mu squared. And that gives you three integrals. But this integral, the integral of f of x dx, just gives you 1. And this integral just gives you your average. So you get the average value of x squared minus 2 times mu times the average value of x plus mu squared, which is the average value of x, minus 2 mu squared plus mu squared. So in practice, this is the way that you compute variances. This is the definition. But this is the practical formula. So let's see how that worked for our examples. For the standard uniform, the average value of x squared, well, we have to integrate x squared times f of x. And that just gives us a third. And then our variance is the average value of x squared minus our average value squared. So it's a third minus a half squared. A third minus a quarter is a twelfth. For the standard exponential, you have to figure out the average value of x squared f of x dx. You have to do that integral. You have to integrate by parts twice, and the answer is 2. You subtract off the average value of x squared, and you get 1. For the normal distribution, we're actually going to do it from the definition. We're going to take x minus mu squared times the density function. And if you do an integration by parts with u equals x minus mu, then that turns into this integral, which is exactly sigma squared times the integral of f of x dx. And you don't have to even do that integral. You know that it integrates to 1. So that gives you sigma squared. So the upshot, finally, we've got a name for the width. The variance gives you the squared width. The standard deviation, which is usually denoted with the letter sigma, is the square root of the variance. So for our different distributions, for the uniform distribution, we had average a half, and standard deviation, the square root of a twelfth, which is 1 over 2 root 3. For the standard exponential, you had average 1 and width 1. Standard normal, average 0 and width 1. If you did the uniform over an interval from A to B, the average is halfway across, A plus B over 2. And the standard deviation is B minus A over 2 root 3. Exponential, just like the standard exponential, only scaled up by a factor of lambda. And the normal, you've taken this standard thing, you've stretched it up by a factor of sigma to make it sigma wide, and then you've moved it over by a distance mu. And those are the means and standard deviations of all of our standard distributions.